Hello students, in our today's class we are going to study the new chapter Fractional Numbers, chapter number 8 from your class 3 mathematics textbook. Fractional Numbers. Now I have a complete circle here and this is the complete circle, isn't it? It is a circle. Now what I will do is I will cut this circle into two equal parts, okay? I will cut this circle into two equal parts, means this part is equal to this part. So we have two equal parts, right? Now, if I have to take only one part, okay, I'll take only one part. I call it as half. Isn't it? I call it as half. This is the half. So what I did here is, I had one complete circle. I made two equal parts and one of the part from the two equal parts is called as half. Now you see this one. I have a page. I will divide that page into two equal parts. So this is one page. I will divide into two equal parts and I will use one side of it. So I will call this as half. Okay, I'll call this as half. See some examples from your textbook. One roti divided into two equal parts, that half part is half roti. One page divided into two equal parts, that is half page. One cake divided into two equal parts becomes half. One biscuit cut into two pieces, that is half biscuit. One square cut into two equal parts, that is half part is colored here. You see here half part is colored. See this picture now. Half of the glass is filled with water, right? And half of the glass is empty. Half of the glass is filled with water. Half of the glass is empty, isn't it? See the second picture. This is a square, isn't it? This is a square. Half of the square is colored. Half of the square is not colored. Half of the circle is red. Half of the circle is green. Some pictures are given below. Can you divide all the possible pictures into two equal parts using a dotted line? Yes, first one is already done here. Second one, you have to divide the scale into half, isn't it? So, I can divide it this way. At the center, you have to draw the dotted line here like this. Dotted line. How to divide the shirt? You can divide it this way. Next, bag. You have to divide it half equal parts. So, you have to divide it this way. 9. How to divide 9 into equal parts? Is it possible to divide 9 into equal parts? No, it is not possible. So, divide the clock. Then the pot. Then the letter D like this. Then the bell. Remaining, you have to do it by yourself. Observe, the half part of the letters are given below and complete it by writing the remaining half. See here, A half is given. Here it is completed. Now here, which letter might be this? This is letter B, isn't it? Letter B. You can divide it this way. Next, this is O. This is, yes, you are right. This is M. If we keep one half on the other hand, they coincide each other. They coincide each other. In two equal parts, each part is a half. This is a half, this is the other half. If we join two halves, we get a whole. We get a whole. Now you see this square. You see this square. Square is divided into four equal parts, right? Four equal parts, and one part is colored. A square is divided into four equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4. In that one part is colored, right? So it is not a half. If there is a whole, must be divided into two parts. But here there are four equal parts. So we call it as a quarter. We call it as a quarter. Okay. The square is divided into four equal parts and one part is colored. That means quarter of the square is colored. You see this. How much water is there in the drum? If we divide the drum into four equal parts, 1, 2, 3, and 4, among four equal parts, one of the part is filled with water or oil. That means quarter of the drum is filled, isn't it? How much of the chocolate did Putti eat? There were four equal parts and she ate one part here. That means she ate quarter part of the chocolate. The shaded portion of the picture is not the quarter. This is here it is colored, here it is shaded. That is not the quarter. Why? Because these are not equal parts. These are not equal parts. But you see here, these are equal. This is equal to this, this is equal to this, and this is equal to this one. Here it is not equal. All four are not equal. So we say that this is not the quarter. But these are equal four parts. These are equal. If four parts, if there are four equal parts, each part is a quarter. So this is one quarter, this is other. So each part is a quarter. Half of half is a quarter. So half of half. So one chocolate is divided into four parts. So half means two parts. So in that one of the part is quarter. In a whole there are four quarters. So whole is the full chocolate. So one of the part is the quarter. So in the whole there are four quarters. See this example. Here the plus sign is divided into four equal parts and one part is colored. So we call it as one quarter. One quarter. But here you see, it is divided into four parts and two parts are colored, right? So we can call it as two quarter or one half, because half of the part is colored. See the third one. How many parts are colored here? Three parts are colored. We call it as three fourth or three quarter. Here the complete plus sign is colored. So one whole is colored. One whole is colored. Exercise 8.1. Write the indicated parts as shown in the example. Here in the circle is divided into two parts and one part is colored. So shaded part is half, unshaded part is half. You see here, next, a square is divided into two equal parts and one part is colored, one part is not colored. So unshaded part is half, shaded part is also half. See, a rectangle is divided into four equal parts. So red colored part and green colored part. So green colored part, how many green colored parts are there? One. So one among four parts. So we call it as quarter. Here red color three are there. So we call it as three fourth. See here. Four equal parts and one part is shaded. So shaded part is quarter. Unshaded part is three fourth.